GPT-4 has finally been released. This model is one of OpenAI's biggest milestones in AI. The biggest difference of the GPT-4 from other state-of-the-art models is that it is multimodal. It means that we are giving text in ChatGPT, but now we will be able to give this new model in visuals. GPT-4 accepts text and visual prompts. To better understand this, let's look at an example in the GPT-4 demo video. First, as you can see, he is sketching a mock-up on paper. Next, he is taking a photo of this mock-up. Finally, he is giving this visual to GPT-4 and asking to convert this mock-up to a colorful website. That's it. GPT-4 gives the necessary codes. As you can see, the model recognized the image and outputted the necessary codes. It's amazing. In this way, you can draw the website you want on paper and create it in a few seconds with GPT-4. Like ChatGPT, you can also give text as input to GPT-4. To explain this, let me show you a few examples. Let's say you want to build a game, but you don't want to deal with writing code. You say the game you want is GPT-4. Bam! The model gives you the codes of the game. You can make your game using these codes. Let's take a look at another example. Tell GPT-4 to make a snake game using JavaScript and the necessary HTML and CSS codes. GPT-4 gives you the necessary codes. Cool, you can do a lot more with GPT-4. At the end of this video, you will understand better what you can do with GPT-4. Let's take a look at what we will cover in this video. First, we will explore what exactly GPT-4 is. To understand the power of GPT-4, we will compare it with its previous version, GPT-3.5. We will look at how to access GPT-4. Finally, we will find out what the GPT-4 API price is. Okay, we briefly talked about the topics we will cover in this video. Let's get started with what exactly GPT-4 is. You've seen how wonderfully GPT-4 overcomes human-level tasks. But what is GPT-4 under the hood? GPT-4 is based on Transformers architecture developed by the Google Brain team in 2017. Transformers is based on the encoder and decoder. This architecture was revolutionary and worked great, especially in language-to-language translation tasks. That's why Google Translate does human-level translations. There are two important models based on this architecture. One of them is BERT and the other is GPT. BERT is mostly used for tasks like text classification, while GPT is mostly used for generating text. So, GPT-4 is based on Transformers architecture. This model was trained with data on the internet. You know, working with this big data is not easy. To train the model, a supercomputer was designed within 2 years with Azure. The GPT-3.5 model was trained last year to test this system. Think about it. ChatGPT, which fascinated the whole world, was built on GPT-3.5. You can also understand the power of GPT-4. Nice, we've seen the architecture behind GPT-4 and have a brief look at the development process. To understand what you can do with GPT-4, let's take a look at a few examples OpenAI shows on its webpage. For example, when you give a picture like this to the model, and you say define the picture panel by panel, the model understands what is in the image and explains it to you. GPT-4 says, it's a three-panel lightning cable adapter package. And the model is describing the objects in the panels one by one. Awesome, right? Let's take a look at this picture. As you can see, a man is ironing in the back of the taxi. Isn't it an unusual event? We understand that the situation in this picture is absurd. When we ask the GPT-4 what's unusual in this picture, the model describes what is happening in the picture. Think about it, the model first recognizes the objects in the image like a human. AI models were already able to do object recognition. But the model discovered something unusual in the picture. In other words, he notices the picture almost like a human and makes inferences. In another example, when you give the model a few pages of articles and ask it to summarize, the model detects the texts in the image and summarizes the article for you. If you say to explain the second table specifically, it also describes the table to you. Amazing. If someone had said 5 years ago that AI would recognize objects in pictures and make inferences, no one would have believed him. But now, look at the level AI has come to in such a short time. The previous version of GPT-4 was GPT-3.5. As you know, ChatGPT was developed using this model. Let's compare the GPT models to better understand the GPT family. The GPT family has accomplished the impossible. The two latest members of the GPT family are GPT-3.5 and GPT-4. Let's compare them to understand better. The first difference is that, while GPT-3.5 only works with text data, GPT-4 can also work with visual and video data, apart from text data. This is the biggest difference between the two models. As for the number of parameters, GPT-3 had 175 billion parameters. GPT-4 has 100 trillion parameters. What a large model, right? So, this model is about 500 times larger than the GPT-3. Now, let's compare the two models in terms of conversation. In simple conversation, there is no difference between these two models, but for complex conversations, GPT-4 is excellent. GPT-4 is more reliable, creative, and able to handle much more nuanced instructions than GPT-3.5. So, this model works great with text data as well. Let's move on to the exam comparison, which OpenAI especially highlights. The GPT-4 performs at the human level in academic and professional examinations, although it is less capable than a human at solving real-world problems. If you have GPT-4 with you, in an academic or professional exam, you can easily score high. OpenAI researchers tested GPT-3.5 and GPT-4 on human exams. These exams consist of both multiple choice and open-ended questions. In the image on the screen, you can see the exams and the success of the models in these exams. The graph is ranked from low to high by the performance of the GPT-3.5. Blues indicate the success of GPT-3.5, and greens indicate the success of GPT-4. If you notice, GPT-4 performs better in almost all exams. The GPT-4's success in most exams exceeds 80%, and in some it is close to 100%. These exams are not simple, they are academic and professional exams. Note that, these exams are the tests that most people fail. So far, many models have been developed that are trained on big data. Various benchmark tests are used to compare these models. These tests, for example, measure how the model predicts word after word. Generally, these tests are in English. In this chart, you see the scores of models in various languages. In the first row, it shows the percentage of finding the correct answer when a random answer is chosen. The probability of finding the correct answer in a four-choice quiz is 25%, right? For example, the test score of the POM model, developed by Google, is 69% for the English language, 70% for the GPT-3.5 model, and 85% for the GPT-4. Unbelievable! The GPT-4 outperformed other models in benchmark tests. When these tests were translated into other languages and tested in that language, GPT-4 is great again. GPT-4 scores better than its competitors. It's amazing. Okay, GPT-4 is an excellent model, but you might ask, is there any downside to it? Despite the high capabilities of this model, it has some limitations, like other members of the GPT family. OpenAI researchers compared the accuracy rates of the GPT family. There are areas on the horizontal axis, and the accuracy rates of the models on the vertical axis. The closer this ratio is to 1, the more ideal humanoid responses are obtained. Look at this chart, the green color indicates GPT-4. In the tests, the GPT-4 gives more accurate outputs than other models, but unfortunately, we see that it cannot give a 100% correct answer. So, GPT-4 needs a little more improvement to get exact results. Okay, in this section, we have compared the GPT models. And we saw how powerful the GPT-4 is. But, we mentioned that the model also has some limitations. Let's see where you can use GPT-4 now. Guys, this section will walk you through how to access GPT-4. As you know, OpenAI recently introduced a paid subscription to ChatGPT. You can subscribe to ChatGPT for $20 per month. You can use GPT-4 directly if you have a subscription. If you don't have a subscription, another way to use this model is to sign up for the waitlist and wait your turn. I don't know when it will be your turn. Even if it does, they'll likely offer limited use. In other words, they direct you to a paid subscription. When it's your turn, the GPT-4 model will be open to you on the OpenAI Playground page. Another way to access GPT-4 is to use Bing. As you know, Bing is a search engine developed by Microsoft. ChatGPT was used in this engine before. Yusuf Mehdi, corporate vice president at Microsoft, announced that they changed the engine behind Bing's preview to GPT-4. So, you can access GPT-4 using Bing Chat. But, for that, you still have to sign up for the waiting list. There are other ways to access GPT-4, but I have described the easiest ones. If there is a method you know, write it in the comments. In this section, we talked about how to access GPT-4. Let's take a look at the pricing of the GPT-4 API. Developers can use GPT models in their applications. So, you can connect GPT models to your own applications as APIs. I have good news for you. You can use the GPT-4 API in your applications immediately. The ChatGPT API was released a little late. OpenAI has made GPT-4's API immediately available. Now let's take a look at the GPT-4 API pricing. Pricing is based on tokens. Token means a string of characters. So, you can think of the token as the smallest piece of text. It can be a token, a symbol, or a word. You might think that 1,000 tokens equals about 750 words. Here, you can see the prices of the models according to the token usage. For example, 2,133 tokens equal about 1,600 words. You can write a Medium blog post with this word count. It costs $0.128 for completion and $0.064 for the prompt. The price for the GPT-3.5 is $0.004. You can see the prices of other models here. Of course, these models are not as powerful as the GPT-4. Let's look at the highest number of tokens. That equates to about 1 million words. You can write Harry Potter books with this word count. So, writing Harry Potter books with GPT-4 costs $43 by using the prompt. GPT-4 for the prompt is 14 times more expensive than ChatGPT and 29 times more expensive to complete. So, is it worth the difference? It depends on you. You saw the power of GPT-4 in the charts. This model gives more accurate and more nuanced outputs. The decision is yours. This is how the GPT-4 API charges. In this video, we saw the power of GPT-4 and examined its limits. What are your thoughts about this model? Is it worth subscribing to use this model? I'm curious about your answers, write in the comments. Before you finish the video, don't forget to subscribe, like the video, and share it with your friends.